Welcome to 5-Minute Hacks, the series that shows that knowledge is power. In each episode, we'll explore various ways to learn about hacking and how to use Project Discovery's open source tools, all in quick 5-minute segments. Get ready to learn some amazing hacks and have some fun along the way. And remember, there's always more to discover, so join us and let's get hacking. In today's video, we're going to help you contribute your first Nuclei template to the public repository of Nuclei templates. Once your contribution is accepted, not only will you be able to brag to all of your friends and colleagues that you are a Project Discovery contributor, but your work will also be used by tens of thousands of security engineers to run millions of scans every month. And you'll be doing your part to help us all fulfill Project Discovery's mission to democratize security. But first, what is a Nuclei template? Well, we're going to skip over most of that in this video. If you want to learn more about Nuclei templates, how they work, and how you can start writing your own Nuclei templates, we recommend you check out our Nuclei Fundamentals YouTube series. We'll have that linked in the description below. But remember, once you've become familiar with Nuclei templates, you can start contributing your ideas right away. You don't have to be an expert to become a contributor. What's that? You're back, and now you've written your own custom Nuclei template, and you're ready to contribute it? That's great! Let's take a look at the template that we're going to contribute together today. This template is in the OSINT category, as it identifies if a provided username has a public profile or not on threads.net from Meta. OSINT templates are useful to do some open source intelligence gathering for you or your offensive security program. In this case, we can see that we are looking for a provided user at threads.net and that there's a 200 status and a canonical link in the header. And we've also included all of the relevant metadata in the template, given it a unique ID, and listed ourselves as the author. We've also tested and verified this template both with positive and negative use cases, as we can see here. Getting this contribution added to the Nuclei template repository for the whole world to use is as easy as Pi. In fact, let's use Pi to discuss the three critical steps: fork, push, and pull. The first step is to get a repository where we can stick our own fork into it by forking the Nuclei template repository on GitHub into our own workspace. Fork in this case means we create our own copy of the Nuclei template repository that we can then introduce changes into. To fork the repository, we go to github.com/projectdiscovery/nuclei-templates like this. Assuming we're signed into GitHub already, forking the repository is easy as clicking the fork button, and then deciding which namespace do we want to put the fork into, and then go ahead and click Create Fork. Next, we need to push our change into our fork. To accomplish this, we can either clone the repository onto our computer, or hit the period button on your keyboard, and the repository will open in GitHub code spaces. Next, navigate to the correct folder for this template to live in. In this case, for an OSINT template, they live under HTTP and then OSINT. We can right-click on that folder and say New File. Give that file a name, and then paste in the template that we created earlier. You can see that the Git icon on the left has lit up to show us that we have one uncommitted file. If we go there, we can review our changes, enter a commit message, and click Commit and Push. Now, if we go back to our repository fork on GitHub, we can start the process to request Project Discovery to pull our new change into the main line of their repository. To do this, click Pull Requests and then New Pull Request. We'll see that GitHub automatically compares our forked repository to the main upstream repository and shows the commit we just made along with the changes. Click Create Pull Request and you'll see the title of the PR defaults to our commit message. We can then enter the necessary data into the body of the pull request and create their pull requests. And that's it! Someone from our open source templates team will review your requests and may ask some follow-up questions to understand exactly how the template is validated. Once they're confident in our team's understanding of the template, it will be added to the main repository, and the next time Nuclei templates are released, your template will join others used by millions of scans. That's why at Project Discovery, we like to say that we're democratizing cybersecurity together. Thank you for joining us on this 5-Minute Hack. We hope you discovered something new. If you want to stay in touch with Project Discovery, join our Discord server at nux.gg/discord. That's nux.gg/discord. Until then, happy hacking.